Yep. Hey, phone number for Loveline. 1-800-LOVE-191. Facts are 310-854-4455. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. Dr. Drew is a board-certified physician and addiction medicine specialist. And tonight we have a vivid adult film actress, Kobe Tai, in here. Kobe is... Kobe's 5'3 and 90 pounds, which I like because it makes my penis look bigger. You know what I mean? I mean, seriously, if you're with a
woman who's 5'9 and 145, then your 6-inch 9-ounce penis gets reduced to 4.5 inches. 5 ounces. Just but if that woman gets shrunk, then your penis grows. Do you understand? And that's why, why I like Kobe.
That's why you keep that snow globe with the village.
That's right, so that my penis can actually crush an entire village. Also, sometimes will lie on the, Drew, I've told you this, I will lie out on my lawn, hold my penis up when a 747 flies by going into Burbank Airport and obscure the entire plane. Therefore, using the logic that my penis is larger than a 747 because my penis has obscured the entire 747.
From your vision, yes.
Well, that's all.
I bet your neighbors love that.
Oh, yes. They're big fans of my penis. All right, so Kobe has been in, Lotus, Lethal Affair, Ancient Asian Sex Secrets. I love that.
Self-explanatory.
Let me tell you, I love the Asians in the porn. I think the Asians were made for porn. That's my take on it. Because what do you need? I'll tell you the three or four things you need for porn to make a good porn star. You need tan skin, because lily white skin does not hold up with the lighting in the video. The Asians have that. You have the lack of hair. They're not hairy people, the Asians. No hair on them. Look at that. Look at Kobe. Nothing there. Drew has slightly less hair, but Drew's a freak. No hair, dark skin, enthusiasm. The Asians, they're pretty reserved folks in general, but they cut loose when it comes to sex. Like, they're all pent up in their everyday life, and then they just explode. Isn't that kind of weird? Like, you know, a lot of bowing and hi and stuff like that. And then all of a sudden it's like, let's grind up some rhino horn and bang hookers all night.
Cow.
And I'm gonna eat
tiger
some
pancreas.
Endangered species off of her crotch, you know? I mean, what is that? So these are all good makings for a porn star, and that's what you have. Kobe is beautiful. We never met before, have we?
No, and I've actually been dying to meet both of you for quite a while, so thank you for having me.
Oh, really?
Come on.
All right. So, originally from Taiwan,
mm-hmm.
What's the story? Chinese and Japanese? I'm reading the stat sheet
half
here.
Half and half, and I was born in Taipei.
And what got you into this business? Because everyone has a story.
Well, I was adopted by Americans when I was 5 months old. My dad was a jet flyer, and he was in the Navy, and he was transferred there, and they adopted me when I was 5 months, so then that's how I got to America.
Where was he stationed?
In Taipei.
Oh, he was in Taipei.
Uh-huh.
He got transferred to a base in Taipei.
Uh-huh.
He adopted you in Taipei.
Mm-hmm. My family adopted me. Mother, sister, father adopted me when I was 5 months.
And your biological?
Were you in an orphanage?
Biological was, biological mother was Chinese, biological father was Japanese.
But what happened to your biological parents?
He said he would marry her if she had a son, because the son's working the fields, and there's no stem on this apple. So he went back to being a soldier, and she couldn't take me back to her parents or grandparents without a father for the baby, because you'd be disowned, lose face, and might as well commit suicide. It's like an awful thing. So she gave me up to the Catholic orphanage, because she knew that Americans adopt from Catholics, which they did.
So you went to the orphanage when you were five?
Mm-hmm, St. Benedictine. Mm-hmm.
And you were just...
No, 5 months, 5 months.
Oh, so you were raised in the orphanage until you're 5 years old.
Actually, I wasn't there that long. I was five, you know, she... Peter tottered with the idea of what she was going to do.
She was adopted at 5 months.
Yeah.
Oh, 5 months. I thought it was 5 years.
No,
for some
5 months, yeah.
Oh, okay.
But I did have a lot of hair. And it's funny because my mom and dad said, I swear to God, Kobe, you could tell the difference between Americans and the Asians, because the Asians would be like, yeah, whatever. And the Americans would come by and I'd be like a dog at the pound. I'd be like, hey.
Oh, wow.
And, so I knew the difference.
And you, so you were adopted at 5 months old from your father, not biological father, but your adopted
father.
Is a fighter jock, right? Mm-hmm. What do you fly?
The jets.
Which one?
This is hard hearing right now. Like, Dad, hello.
That's probably bad. Drew wishes his dad stood around a jet engine for a while. You wouldn't have to talk to him as much. But your mom could have gone out on the tarmac, too, once in a while, but it's not as good. Especially Drew's kid's party that talked my ear off for an hour, 45 minutes, a couple of highballs in there. But what did he fly? Was he...
He was a chief yeoman. And then he flew some jets, and he was in the Navy 20 years.
You don't know what jets he flew, though. That's what I love about
women. Well, you
know,
I see pictures with...
Wow.
They were gray.
Did he fly in Vietnam?
No, he didn't go to Vietnam. I know that.
All right. So let's talk about... enough about the family. Let's segue into pornography. So you were adopted in Taipei.
Mm-hmm. And then he got stationed to Miramar. San Diego.
Right. So you moved to San Diego, mm-hmm. and is that where you were raised?
That is where I lived until I was 5 and a half. And then Dad and Mom are from the South, and that's where I moved to, and that's where I grew up, and that's where I went to college, and that's
South
where
East.
They are now. Arkansas.
And where'd you go to college?
University of Arkansas.
And how the hell did you get into this sleazy business? I mean...
I love this business.
Yeah, but what went wrong? I mean, what happened?
One would wonder, wouldn't you?
Well, you never... There's always a story. I mean, maybe the adopted part is enough, but you were 5 months old, you know? 5 months is
fine. Well, I did not grow up going, wow, I want to be a porn star. No, I did not.
Right.
I worked in a law office because my dad did, and I thought that's what I should do. I worked for GMAC when I was in college because I knew everything about the Smart Lease program, and
sure.
They have great benefits, and they celebrate every fucking holiday. GMAC does.
All right,
I loved
so
it.
You get out. They're like the Jews over there. They go to work 4 days out of the week.
That's what it was like. But
And how did you get into the adult film industry? That's the question.
Okay. So my boyfriend in college got a job transfer to Cleveland, Ohio.
Uh-huh.
And we moved to Cleveland. That was the first time I was away from my roots. And you kind of let your hair down when you do that. And so I was a nanny for a while. And then there's all these pretty girls in my apartment complex. And then all these boats and cedars. And I'm like, what do they do? They're my age. How could they possibly have all
this? What city are you in at this
Cleveland.
Point? Cleveland. In Cleveland?
And there is a Tiffany's Cabaret in Cleveland, Ohio,
uh-huh.
ladies and gentlemen. And it's always the top five. I mean, we're talking really nice. And so I went down by word of mouth that I should go there from the people that I nannied for. No doubt. And I won amateur night, started working the next day.
And how long ago was this?
Oh, man, this was five.
5 years ago?
5 and a half years ago, yeah.
And how old were the kids you were nannying for?
Only one, Erica. She was 9 months old.
Oh, I thought it was a guy. Guy'd be going insane. Could you imagine?
My nanny was going
Could you imagine if you got hold of a porn movie with your nanny of some years, your hot Asian nanny for some years, you know, like she was your nanny from the time you were like six, the time you were 11. Now five years later, you're 16 years old, and you get hold of a porn with your hot Asian nanny. I'd be like, you'd be holding it up over your head. I mean, could you imagine?
Either you want to kill yourself. Or your parents. Why'd you let her go?
Oh, well, no, I would just go into the room, lock the door, put an IV in my arm, and just yank on myself until something came off. I really would. Hey, Anderson, you know what I did tonight, Drew?
I don't want to know. Did something come off?
Because I knew
did
Kobe.
Fall off?
No.
Tear something off?
I knew Kobe
was... Do I have to get his suture material out tonight?
How about
no,
those barnacles?
I'm getting old. I really am.
Yeah, what happened?
Well... But a couple of things. First off, you know, I like the vintage porn. A buddy of mine...
With the Atari music that they play in the background?
Yeah, yeah. a buddy of mine, the Wii, said they should start a vintage porn channel. You know, that would be real good. All those movies, all that Behind the Green Door and Weekend
great.
Roulette and Deep Throat and, of course, the whole Taboo series, 1 through, you know, 45 or however many they made. I mean, you could watch all that vintage stuff from the 70s, John Holmes and all those.
Ron Jeremy.
For television, they call
Ron
that.
Ron spans many decades.
They call that TV land. What would you call it? What would your channel be called?
Semenville. But the point is I got home, I got hold of this... I've been wanting to see Taboo 2 for a long time. I remember it from my youth, you know. And I got it from a guy in a band who gave it to me. And I was driving home from his house about 12:30 at night the other night.
Yeah,
I left the show early to go get it. It was that important. And I thought to myself, I am going to go at it maybe 5-6 times, I thought.
Why am I such a loser? It's like Grandpa
I was like,
from the Rugrats.
And I started in on myself, you know, and I was like, all right, this is just number one. Maybe six. Maybe I'll do like a baker's dozen. I'll do 13, you know. And it was like, What time is it? Jesus, I'm hungry. I gotta turn in. I'm disgusted at myself. How much time did I spend thinking about this? And I went right to bed. And, you know, a few years ago, I would have at least got the hat trick off, but not anymore. Not at the ripe old age of 35.
Before you got disgusted, too.
Come on, what are you doing with your life, man? All right, so, Anderson, you got that tape yet? I taped the theme song from Taboo 2 today, and I want you just to dig on this. This is what I have to endure.
Set the scene. What's actually happening?
There's no sex here. They're just walking. Listen.
Karen Carpenter.
Oh, yes, he does. Just listen to the lyrics. No, you were wrong. About guys banging his sister.
Why would we ever revisit a decade that produced crap like that?
Really? I don't know, but she... I recorded that. Now, see, it's off a bad tape, but what you're hearing is cars going by because it was a scene where they were leaving their high school and the two girls were walking out front of some high school. There's like high school kids standing around in a porn movie. I have no idea they're in a porn movie, but the point is... She's singing about this guy, and this guy is banging his sister and his mom. You know? And it's like, he's got it all. Yes, he does. We may have to hear that again later in the show.
That is a
hot song. Can you picture the woman who cut that in like 1978 thinking, this is my big break? You know what I mean? She was like a young Joan Baez, right? And she's thinking, first this, then I start scoring Oscar-caliber movies. I mean, this is just...
Me and Burt Bacharach.
Sitting in a recording studio with bad wood paneling in 1978, listening to this on playback, and a bunch of people nodding their heads, really come together.
Really, it's kind of good. It's kind of that scene from Boogie Nights where the guys produce their own record.
Right.
Remember that?
It's a little departure from your normal porn soundtrack, but I wish you'd get back to more acoustic, more of a...
The Karen Carpenter
scene. Yeah.
I agree,
that was
Kobe.
Good. Oh, Kobe, this is great. I have some of your movies here to bring home, right?
Yes, you do.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, yes.
I'll tell you, that is
shall
the
I bring
part.
A suture set tomorrow?
You're going to have to sew my penis back on.
That's what I figured.
All right, so what are we plugging here, Kobe, before we get to the vividvideo.com?
Yes, that's Vivid's website.
What would they find on that?
Actually, Vivid has a great selection of different girls. I believe there are 9 of us, and we've got your blondes, we've got your Asians, we've got your brunettes, you name it, we've got it. And they're great girls, they're a lot of fun, and you can find out about each one of us on vividvideo.com. And then there's my own website, www.kobetai.com, and that is pretty self-explanatory.
Oh, and you were the crazy call girl in Very Bad Things.
Yes, I was.
You were the one they killed, right?
I was the bad thing.
Yeah, you didn't see that. It was way out there, that movie, but it was kind of cool.
I loved it.
And Kobe had a nice part in it. I mean, she was had the back of her skull mashed, run through with a robe hanger on the back of a door. But
what a way to go, huh? Having sex.
Yeah, but that's kind of cool.
I had a lot of fun doing that, definitely.
Mm. All right, can we hear the theme?
No,
Taboo 2 again. He's got it all.
You can listen during the break. You can sit in the booth and just listen and relive your youth. Isn't that...
Kelly?
Yeah.
You're 16?
Yes, I am.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, I want to say that, Adam, you rock and I admire you a lot.
Admire him?
Sure.
Well, I do.
I'm a role model.
What do you admire?
Just him. He's really funny and he gets his, like, opinions across and his points, and I don't know.
Okay.
And also, Drew, I find you very, like, intelligent, and I think that you do a very good job.
Well, thank you. What's going on?
Basically, like, a couple of days ago, like, on Sunday night, I had my boyfriend over and two friends of mine. And basically, me and my boyfriend started fooling around in my room, and the friends were outside just watching TV in the living room. And then the next thing I knew was that they, like, knocked, but they came in right after they knocked. And they walked on me doing stuff with him. And they kind of, like, they're now ignoring me and not talking to me. And I don't know whether...
The friends, are these male friends?
No, it's girls.
They're sort of giving you a cold shoulder now.
Yes, and I don't know whether it's because of what they saw or because...
What were you doing?
Well, basically he was going down on me, and, like, he was just decided to be really, like... Well, he was just digging things in.
Ooh. He was what?
Things?
Well, he had a marker that was just, like... It was just, like, a marker lying around, and he, like, decided, he was like, can I try that? And
do you guys think that, do you think that your friends are real embarrassed, or did you share
did
some sort
draw
of...
draw a mustache on you?
No, because when I came out to the living room, I kind of sat quiet, and I was like, hey, can I have the remote? They're like, sure, just don't mind us, and then they kind of, like, we'll see you around, and they kind of, like, left, but, like, they stuck around for a couple of minutes, but then they left, and ever since, like, I tried to call one of them.
Are they virgins?
Yes,
that's probably what it
maybe
is.
Maybe they were a little bit freaked out.
Yeah, they freaked out. Or have you guys always sort of shared some sort of philosophy that you wouldn't do this, or that you don't agree that this would be something you wouldn't be doing until you're older, or something like that that you shared with them?
I don't know. You see, I told them that me and him do stuff, but they kind of, like, they find him attractive somewhat. You know, they're like, yeah, he's really...
Do you think they're envious or jealous?
That's what I'm thinking. I don't know whether what to think.
Only he could shove a marker up me, they're probably thinking.
No.
Is that the balloon over your head?
Yeah.
I see the arrows.
For me, it's a box of crayons, but that's me.
All right, Kelly, look, we can't really reach into their minds and figure out what their problem is. If they're your friends, you keep reaching out to them, they'll connect, but they're probably just embarrassed and freaked out.
Yeah.
I give Kobe my number two pencil later. You know what I'm saying?
After we sew it back on? Or
you don't yeah. have a kindergartner pencil, the real fat ones?
No. No, unfortunately not. I have the ones they give you when you play miniature golf. You know, they have a big bucket. You reach in, grab a handful. Those little ones you have to, like, scrape on the
you
cement
get
to get sharp.
Too.
You know, the ones you keep score on a golf card with. Yeah. Yeah. Mike, Michelle?
Yeah.
You're 17.
Yeah, Adam, let me just say... You gotta, like, stay off the porn. That is too funny. I mean, you're a grown man obsessed with, like, something from, what was it, 1979?
That's his childhood. He's obsessed. Does he talk about anything else in the show but his childhood? does it surprise you that he'd be stuck on the things he watched back then?
He's a child in a grown man's body.
It's, like, way too funny. Oh, my God.
Let's hear a little more thing. Just a little more. Come on. He knows how to please in every detail. Are you listening to this? Oh, come
Michelle,
on.
Michelle, what's going on?
Oh, my God. Okay, well.
He knows how to please in every detail. People don't write songs like that anymore, you know?
See, they don't. Michelle?
Calm down, Adam. Okay, I just want to say, first of all, I called a while, like a month and a half ago or so. And I talked to you about, I was getting my mom arrested and stuff, and you guys were like, well, drop the charges. I just want you to know that I did. But I still got her son, like, kicked out of school from my school.
Her son?
I don't remember this call. You're getting your mom arrested?
A stepmom.
What for?
Well, because her son tried to, like, rape me, but she came in. And all she said was that she
talked
to him, but that's it.
Right. Okay, good.
And, I just want to nudge off the charges, but, yeah. And,
How old is he?
He was 19.
All
right. Oh, boy.
Okay, my question right now is, like, what's the major effects of steroids? Because I'm on the cross-country team, and everybody on there takes it, and the coach only lets the seniors take it. I mean, we all know it's illegal and everything, but I just...
Okay, for a girl, it's a very bad idea.
Your coach should be arrested. Steroids or androstenedione?
They're what?
Steroids or androstenedione? You mean, like, Deca and that kind of thing?
Yeah. Yeah, we know it's illegal. No one says anything.
It's not Anderstein Dye. You're not talking about the stuff you get at a health food store.
No.
See, you're not talking about steroids, like steroids that you would inject or take in a pill. I mean, you're not talking about, you know, NFL pro wrestling steroids, are you?
Well, I know they're illegal. That's what I'm talking about. They're pills.
So
you pop them or you can inject them in you.
Well, yeah. As a woman, it can make your voice lower. It can make your clitoris huge, almost like a penis.
Yes, it can make your jaw and your face
make your Adam's apple project, and people will know.
Permanently grow hair on your face.
Steroids on the cross country team, for Christ's sake.
The cosmetic aspects are the best thing that can happen to you. The worst thing. Stroke, heart disease, liver failure, kidney failure. Your coach should be arrested.
Yeah.
Seriously, this is scandalous.
Anderson, let's get some theme music underneath Drew when he's talking about this, please.
This is Michelle. This is scandalous.
I'm talking about real.
To me, this is national level news that a coach knowingly allows his players, females. And be on steroids. It is profoundly dangerous and potentially life-threatening. Never meant to be used on healthy people. High blood pressure. Look back on the bodybuilders the last 20, 30 years, and not a lot of them live into their 60s.
Maybe you do.
Just check that out.
But you don't.
And I personally have seen, in addition to the organ difficulties, depressions, suicide, manic episodes.
And people don't want to be around you because of your mood swings.
Yes,
and it cosmetically be a mess. I guess that's what she's hearing. So, okay.
We're going to take a little break. Kobe Tai is here. She is she's built like a burlap sack full of bobcats.
Ow!
I'll tell you what. She's 5'3". She's 90 pounds. And she'll add 3 pounds to any penis. We'll talk to her. She's a really beautiful Asian woman. I mean, just a knockout. So we'll get to her, and we'll hear more theme music from my 1979 movie, Taboo 2, after this.
Loveline. 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 We'll be right back.
Loveline is brought to you by Car Toys and Ray Reese Volkswagen.
Hello. It is Loveline. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. Adult film star Kobe Tai is here, and I know it's radio, so I should describe her. Just flawless and beautiful. Beautiful Asian woman. And petite. I like that. I really do. You know, a lot of guys, they get into that. You know, they want someone who's 6 foot and looks like some kind of runway model. That ain't... I like a petite woman. I like the woman to be a woman. Know what I mean? Makes me feel like more man, right? And we are going
to drop acid before you were here. What?
I sort of feel like I'm in a mushroom flashback or something. But Kobe and I are going to sing the theme from Taboo 2 before the night is through.
Yes!
I can tell you that right now. And Lisa, I mean, you're going to have to transcribe the lyrics so that Kobe and I can have a lyric sheet, because I know, you know, about half of them, but I know Kobe doesn't. And I think the song's starting to grow on Drew.
It is. I see the head bopping.
I'm into it.
I'm really going to belt this one out. And
promise me, though, last quarter hour, last hour of the show.
Not too long from now. We'll do it twice. Well, here's the thing, Kobe. If this works out, we may head into the studio.
Oh, we're going on the road. I'm telling you. I see.
Like I said, remember that scene from Boogie Nights? I'm having a flashback to that.
Dina?
Mystery of life, at last I found you.
Where did that come from?
I don't know. Is that me? Dina?
Hello?
You're 20?
Yeah, my name's Deanna, though.
Oh, Deanna.
Deanna.
Did you saw that drop from Andy Dick last night?
It's
Anderson?
Close enough.
What's up there, Deanna?
Jesus Christ in heaven!
First time caller, long time listener, and like, okay, I've been with the same guy for like 3 years, and like the sex was, you know, pretty good and stuff, and like, I don't know, he's never really been able to like have an orgasm, and then like about a couple months ago, he told me that like, because like we got into an argument about it, and he told me that like, he'd be able to have an orgasm if he was like, you know, could pull my hair a little bit. So I was like, oh, well, you know, whatever. And so I was like, you know, if it makes you feel better. And so, you know, he did. And like, you know, he had an orgasm. And then, like, it just gets, like, more and more extreme. And I just, like, want to know when's it going to end or, like, what should I do?
Well, a real,
like,
a true,
to hurt.
A true fetish is when somebody is dependent on these sorts of distractions in order to function sexually. So he really is a true fetishist in that he can't do it any other way.
Does it bother you?
Well, like, at first, no, but, like, then he, like, wanted to, like, now he wants to, like, spank me and stuff.
Usually it starts to bother a partner because it feels like it's taking the person further away from you. It's, like, not establishing intimacy. It's sort of getting in the way of it, which, in fact, that's what it's designed to do. It's to distract the person from having an emotional connection. His real connection is associated with painful feelings.
Deanna, you had sex with this guy for 3 years and he didn't have an orgasm?
Nuh-uh. And, like, we started to fight over it because...
3 years?
Yeah, well, like, for, like, the past... Well, the first 2.5 years, no orgasm. And then, like, these last 6 months...
Another feature
I've
of fetish.
Been, like, giving into the... You
and
know,
he's, now he's okay. We got that part. Another feature of fetish is people are usually ashamed of it. And they,
but,
so
like,
he's
for
not
the first
2.5 years,
yep. Like, it was nothing. And we used to fight about it. Because I, you know, right. Felt like I could, you know, please him and thought, you know, maybe he was getting it somewhere else.
Deanna, I'm going to keep my fingers crossed here and ask you if you have any kids.
No.
Ah, oh, thank God.
No kids.
What do you do for a living, Deanna?
I'm a student. I'm going to college.
I smell some junior in that college. Is there such thing as junior college? Because
no.
That's what I'm smelling on you.
Junior college.
Just junior college?
Yeah.
But there's no subset of, you know, no junior college?
I hope not.
No. Okay.
Junior college the third.
There's no junior college the second or third?
No.
All right. What are you studying?
I want to be a nurse.
Okay. Pay close attention in class, and if you haven't graduated in 7 years, I want you to remove yourself gracefully from the campus, okay?
Okay.
All right, do not get pregnant from this guy.
Okay.
And do whatever Drew said to do. What'd you say to do, Drew?
I didn't say to do anything, and I'm just saying that you're in.
I don't trust him.
Well, he's got some stuff going on, and it's not going to change, not without a lot of treatment. And in a way, they were better off before with him not orgasming, but at least being present in the...
She would have had 6 abortions and 9 kids by now if this guy was orgasming.
Yeah.
That's weird. I was thinking to myself, I can usually tell in women's voices the ones that either are pregnant or should be pregnant and or have kids. And I was getting, like, half kids in Indiana. And then once in a while, I'm confused, and then it turns out that, like, they're like, oh, my uterus exploded when I was, when I was 11. You know, and I go, oh, okay, all right, now it makes sense again. I never thought about that, but she's been with a guy who hasn't been able to have an orgasm for 3 years. Okay, do not get pregnant.
And she obviously has some real codependency. She can be a nurse and stuff going on with her.
Do not trust the nurse.
Her alcoholic dad and all. But
learning to work in a doctor's world. Josh?
Yeah.
Remember that commercial?
Yeah.
Oh, God, I was watching The Emergency with my kids tonight.
Oh, man.
Man, the 70s were a good time for doctors. Doctors were the doctors, nurses were the nurses.
That's right.
It was very different then.
There wasn't any smart-ass gay dude nurses either running around wearing the same outfits.
The firemen weren't pissed off at you. They just listened to whatever you told them to do.
Yeah, I like that. The nurses back in the day wore nurse outfits.
And hats.
They were white tights and little... And
the cardboard hats.
Kind of hats that you had to clip on, too. They looked like waitresses from Dupar's. And I like that.
No, it was a different...
Now everyone's go. We're all the same. Josh?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, what's up? You're 20?
Yeah, I'm 20. See here. Like, I've been going out with this girl for, like, about 3 months now. And, like, basically, we've hardly done anything, and I think that we probably should have by now, like, just going along the normal course of a relationship, and I would like more stuff to happen, but I don't know how to tell her what I should do.
Is she 20 also?
Yeah, she's 20.
Are you a virgin?
No.
Is she?
Oh, is she? No. Yeah, she's a virgin, yeah.
You sure about that, Josh? I mean, how?
No, yeah, wait, huh? I mean,
how many times, you know, someone like said to a girl you're dating, is she a virgin? Huh? No. I mean, yeah, no. Uh-huh. I mean, it's like, what's going on? Are you watching TV and doing a bong load while you're talking? I mean, how? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it was.
It's like saying.
There's no way, huh?
You have a dog? Yeah, I've had it for 5 years. Yeah, is it neutered? Huh? No, I mean, yeah.
What?
Huh? How does that work? Only our callers can do that. Josh, are you sewing right now?
No.
Knitting.
What are you doing?
I'm in my bed. I was going to fall asleep, but I figured I'd call you guys.
And do you smoke a lot of weed?
No.
Not at all.
I don't get that at all.
Man. Okay. Well, pay attention then. You have no excuse. All right. So no one's a virgin.
No, she is.
She is a virgin. All right. And you think you...
Yeah. You weren't
Will
listening.
You pay attention?
You weren't listening.
Listen, this is what happens when my mom tries to arrange a time for me to come over to dinner. She leaves a message on my phone machine. It sounds like, honey, let's do it Thursday at 6 o'clock. If 6 isn't good, we'll do it 6:45, although if you can pick Grandma up. Although Grandma has a group meeting. Between 7 and 8. 7 and 8 on Thursday. Thursday's not Wednesday. We're going to do it Wednesday at 5:45. If you could pick up Grandma at 5:30, and then you could be by the house at 5:45, and John's going to pick up Thai food, and he should be back by 6:30. So
see you Thursday.
Okay, let's make it Wednesday.
I'll see you Thursday.
And then I hang up the phone, and 2 days goes by, and I think, I got to go to my mom's house for dinner, and I have 400 times and dates running through my head now because I listen to all of them and can't remember what the last one was. You're just like my mother, aren't you, Josh?
Of course. I was just totally confused right there. I didn't know what was going on.
All right, okay. So you're...
Now you get a feeling.
Have you discussed this with her?
Actually, like at one point, I was just blunt. I was like, you know, like, I'd like to do more stuff. I think she just, like, ignored me.
So she didn't want to discuss it.
That's what I think.
What are you doing with her now?
Happy petting?
Break from school, so, like, she lives about, like, 45 minutes away from me, so I've only seen her, like, twice since I got back from school.
Are you being faithful?
No. Except for one time. I mean, she left early for...
Is that a yes or is that a no?
One time he screwed around.
Yes, no way, huh?
Not too much. Like I just kissed some other girl one time.
All right. What have you done with her? Not how far away does she live?
Let me see. What have I done? I've fingered her.
Fingered.
Am I supposed to say that on the radio?
Was your finger attached to your hand, or did you just throw it at her? Kobe does adult films for a living and is offended by the fingering term. All right, so that's something, though, isn't it?
It's
progress. I mean,
it's pretty good for a virgin, right?
Yeah, I mean, like, I've even asked her, like, hey, like, you know, like, can you go down to me and all this stuff? And like, it seems like everything I say, it's just ignored. Like,
when she's ready, she'll do it, and believe me, if you wait and don't pressure her, it'll be so worth the wait.
All right, where are you from, Long Island or Boston, or where are you
Jersey.
From? Oh, that's perfect. I love that. All right, get back to
whatever
you're doing.
You've got to have a non-threatening, non-confrontational, open discussion about what your expectations are of this relationship together. Listen to her. You share your feelings. Find out together what's going on. Maybe there'll be a compromise.
Right.
Maybe not.
Right. Yeah, you got to listen to Kobe. You got a sweet talker. Like, hey, I'll give you some money if you give me a BJ. I'll film it. That's the kind of sweet talking.
With the theme song to Deep Throat in the background.
She's got it all. He's got it all. Yes, he does. We're going to... Listen, Lisa. Oh, wait. Just listen, Drew. And just listen. When they're singing... He knows how to play. It's in every detail.
Every detail.
Well, we're going to sing.
Not now. Not now.
Just give me another 10 seconds of this. Ever imagine... he doesn't stop.
I've been to paradise, but I've never been. That's what that song sounds like.
I want Andy Dick's
job. That's
what it sounds like.
That again, she's singing about a guy who was raping his sister mom. And his mom.
Nice.
He does it with style.
I want to be in that meeting. That was disgusting.
God. Oh. All right. We will take a little break. Kobe Tai is here. I'm going to transcribe the lyrics of that song. We will sing before the night is through. Drew will join in as well.
Thanks a lot, Dr. Drew and Adam.
He will have an oboe solo in the middle of that. And we'll be back after this.
We'll be right back with more.
It's Loveline. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. We're here with adult film star Kobe Tai. Very, not your usual adult film star. Very perky, smart, beautiful. I'm really falling in love. First with myself. I mean, it's important to love yourself first. I mean,
even that
really,
you're tiring up.
Really love yourself, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Really, so you're beginning to remind me of that. You watched Rugrats?
No.
You ever seen it? There's a grandpa. The grandpa? Does he not remind you of that now?
You don't watch Rugrats.
Of course she does.
My boss loves Rugrats.
Your boss?
Marcy.
Marcy?
Mm-hmm.
She's your boss?
Mm-hmm. One of.
Oh, boy. I didn't know. I thought the whole reason you get into porn is to make your own hours and sort of call your own shots. You know what I mean? Why bother? Well, you don't punch a clock or anything, do you?
I do make my own hours, but she's the overhead seeker of everything.
How many movies do you make a year?
Four. So out of 365 days, I do adult, quote-unquote, 12 days.
Wow. So
give or take a few days.
Average movie takes 3 days, or you work on it for 3 days?
Depends on, yeah. It can be up to a week long, and then my day is usually 3 or 4 days.
And, you know, also, they used to... They used to have one star carry an entire film. Now they have them featured, but you're not in 15 scenes.
Right,
you're like
right.
Two or three.
We're on the box cover, so it's easy to find our films, and we are the main character in the story, but there are tons others. Yeah, there's like so many other sex scenes.
Yeah.
We're only in three.
They used to be like, you know, the cast from My Dinner with Andre was bigger. I mean it. I mean, it was like... Seika would do a movie, and it's like first scene, Seika gets it on with a mountain goat, you know? And then second scene, nine guys rape her, you know? And then third scene, if that's the lesbian scene. And the fourth scene's the vibrator scene. And it's, you know, Seika.
Marsha,
Seika. Right, but now it's not Kobe, it's just Kobe. See what I'm saying?
So you don't get bored of me. That's
right.
A good thing.
It was Seika, and now it's just Kobe. All right. That's a culture club song, isn't it?
He almost died, you know. Disco ball fell on his head. Anyway.
Who?
I'm serious.
Boy George.
When?
A big... I'm not kidding.
When was this?
You guys, thank you. My publicist is back there going, yes, she's right.
When?
A big disco ball. He was doing it like rehearsals, and it fell on him, and he nearly died, but he went ahead and did the concert anyway, and I think that's really... funny.
Wow. Yeah, see, I think about that. Like, when I was driving home from the guy's house at 12:30 at night with the porn under my arm, I thought...
What if you died in a car accident?
If I get in a car accident, everyone's just going to laugh their ass off. Oh, my God, what happened? Well, he left the show early to go on a porn run.
But did he have on clean underwear?
officer speculated he started diddling himself while he was getting on the freeway on-ramp and was cut off by an 18-wheeler. Well, that's the way he would have wanted to go.
There was a smile on his face, folks.
Floyd?
Yes.
You're 21.
Mm-hmm.
What's up?
I have a question for Dr. Drew and one for you, Adam.
Mm-hmm. Floyd.
Excuse me?
Yeah, what's up, Floyd?
I have an article here that is talking about the Prevent and Plan B. What it's describing is how Walmart is no longer selling in their pharmacies at all.
Right, that happened many months ago.
Right.
Because those pharmacists were not reading the current literature, which showed quite clearly that their outdated notions that its primary function of that pill was to suppress implantation.
They're pussies and they're not interested. I know you have another point to make, but shut up for one second here, Floyd. Here's my question. You know, there's the religious right and all the right-wingers and all the religious nut jobs are constantly putting together boycotts and they're constantly picketing and they're doing all this stuff. And, you know, NYPD Blue showed some guy's ass, so we're gonna boycott the products that advertise on that network and blah, blah, blah. Where are all the left-wing liberals? How come they never organize? I mean, this is as good a reason to boycott a place like Walmart as anything, and yet you'll never hear about it, and there'll be no organization, there'll be no guy with a bullhorn standing out front of the place, because it isn't in their makeup.
Right, and I completely agree with you, and I listen to you guys every night, and I'm backing it, and the reason I call was, in the middle of this article, it says, in parentheses, it says, which may or may not have been fertilized. The pill prevents an egg which may or may not have been fertilized, and that's why I'm calling to ask Dr. Drew, because I've wondered about that too, and I know he's said many times that the pill, or that the egg hasn't been.
Right, the egg is never released.
What?
The egg is never released.
Okay.
There's never an egg present.
Okay, and so you're saying that they've just got this information from false information.
Well, it took about 10 years for the medical literature to catch up to sort of prove how this pill functions. And you need to know that you know the usual contraceptive pill,
mm-hmm.
right? The all those other pills that are out there
right.
have about the same potential of preventing an implantation. They also can affect the endometrial lining and prevent implantation.
All right.
So if they're going to be consistent in their logic, they're going to have to not sell any birth control pills.
All right, Floyd, what was number two? And listen, feel free to boycott places like Walmart who take stances like that.
Right.
Yeah, we sell guns and ammunition. We just don't sell responsible birth control. There you go. Makes perfect sense when you think about it.
Right.
Idiots.
My question for you is, are you serious when you're saying things about the government stepping in and telling people how many children they should have? I know that you have
yes.
a problem with the permit in the kitchen or the apartment above the garage.
No, it can't have a kitchen in it. Now it can't have it.
Right.
Yes. Am I serious about that?
Yes.
Sure.
You know what? Adam,
absolutely.
Listen.
Listen, if you're on welfare, you get Norplant. I don't want you having kids. Yeah, that's one thing I do as a government. Sure, of course.
It messes up everything else. You don't think, but if you did that, you know that the government's going to turn around and say you can't have the kids, and then
listen to me. Listen to me.
His point is well taken, though.
The government's going to say I can't have kids.
No, it's that the.
Hold on. Shut up, Drew. Why is the government going to say I can't have kids?
I don't know. Why are they?
Okay?
Because Adam, the primary historical transit lesson has taught us there's basically two forces. Ones that let the market take care of itself, and the others where the government steps in and controls everything from above. And whenever somebody decides that they know what's best for other people, immeasurable harm comes to people.
Listen,
But you're making a trade. You're saying if you want support, if you want money from the government, then you anticipate certain behaviors in return, which is different than saying we're going to make laws mm-hmm. that require you to have a certain kind
of
behavior.
Listen, I don't buy this. I don't buy the government hysteria and the paranoia. I don't think if you make assault rifles illegal, guys in black boots are going to kick in your door and take your BB gun away from your kid. That's the way we like to think. It's a certain paranoia, what it does is it just suits people who want assault rifles legal, and they take everything to an extreme. That's ridiculous. Listen, the government tells you how fast you can drive your car, when you get it registered, how much you pay. I gave the goddamn government 600 and something grand last year. What do you mean they're going to tell me what to do? I'm already giving them hundreds of thousands of dollars every year. Could it get any worse than that? And is the government going to tell a guy who makes a lot of money, who pays his taxes, who's totally insured, who's married or what have you, I can't have a kid? Ridiculous. Come on, grow up, everybody. The government is never going to do that.
Yes, Dr.
Please. Well. And the government's not going to do it because the government says a welfare mom has to get on Norplant. They're then going to start telling everyone how many kids they can have. It's paranoia. Please. And believe me, the government tells you what you can and can't do already. Look around. I mean, we can't say certain words on our own goddamn radio show. Why? The government. And when you get in your car and you drive home, you can go a certain speed, but not over that. The government. And part of the money we make tonight's going to the government.
Jizz guzzling?
Please.
Please. Let's take a break.
Worried about the government. All right. I have the lyrics here to...
All right. You guys rehearsed.
He has it all. Okay. This is the theme from Taboo 2 that Kobe Tai and I are going
to
sing.
Why don't we... I got an idea. Why don't we watch the scene and sing, you can sing to the scene so we get the real feel.
I don't have the movie.
I don't think I want to do that.
I taped it.
I'm walking in front of a high school, right?
Yeah. I didn't want to let the film out of my house. My policy.
Maybe we could have a wall between us.
When I transport pornography, I have to have an escort, motorcade.
You've got that Y2K team working in your bunker to make sure there's no snafus.
Speaking of Y2KY.
I have a decoy car that goes the other direction when I transport porn. Yeah, all right. KY, please.
Yeah.
They made it for that Kobe, though. She's tight. Because her hips are about 4 inches from one to the other. That's the
so
OD, outer
imagine.
Dimension. Yes. All right. We're going to take a little break. We'll sing the theme to Taboo 2 when we come back. Hey. Oh, mic's on. It's Loveline. We're going to take a quick 10-second timeout, and then we're going to have a very special moment here on Loveline. Adult film star Kobe Tai. And
just so I don't cry, can I leave the room, walk into the other?
No, you're really going to enjoy this.
You're staying.
And I will sing the theme from Taboo 2 in just 10 seconds. Yeah, all right, Drew, stop saying it. It's Loveline. I'm Adam, that's Drew. Kobe Tai is here. She's a beautiful, beautiful Asian princess. She's an adult film star, and you can see pictures of her doing naughty things, I'm sure, on www.vividvideo.com and also the www.kobetai, which is K-O-B-E-T-A-I. Her real name is Geraldine Schwartz, by the way, .com. And The Awakening is her new adult feature, I'm guessing.
Yes.
She's also the hooker that gets mutilated in Very Bad Things. You may know her from that work. She's vivacious. She's bubbly. She has a beautiful singing voice and a beautiful smile. And we're going to sing the theme to my favorite adult film movie, Taboo 2. Now, we're going to need the music and, we're going to need the music underneath this one. Yeah, I mean, you're going to have to play that, Anderson.
Oh, my God, look at these lyrics.
We'll just sing over it.
Does it with style?
Drew, you're going to have to join. You may want to join in. Do you have the beautiful phone screener and interim producer, Lisa, transcribed the words from the actual theme song. So, again, this is Adam Carolla and Kobe Tai doing the theme from Taboo 2. Oh, wait, re-cue it, I needed just a couple of beats of guitar, isn't that at the top?
And get the barf drop out, too, please.
All right, you ready?
Ready.
All right, All right, we ready? He has it all, yes he does. He knows how to please in every detail. He can do more than you'd ever imagine.
And do it with style. He does it with me. Oh, yes, he does. I know that you thought that you knew him. Well, brother, I'm telling you.
Maybe you did, but you don't.
All right, let's really kick it up here now. He only reveals what he wants. You to see and then to show it all, and then when he does, he satisfies me. Little instrumental here. You only knew just what he could do. You'd want him to if you only knew.
You have it all by yourself. You were just too good.
I really finished with a high falsetto note there that sort of worked, you know?
I'm impressed. Glasses broke. I
like the guitar playing in the background. Drew, that's not bad stuff, is it? Matt?
Hi.
I guarantee both you're going to be singing that on the ride home tonight. You will not be able to get that out of your head. Matt, what's going on?
If that's true, I will drive right out the road.
Matt, what'd you think of my singing?
Oh, man, you're awesome, Adam.
It's a pretty hot song.
You're the coolest person in the world, dude.
It's a song about a guy who rapes his mom and his daughter. That's the beauty of it.
I got to watch that one.
Oh, it's classic. All right, man.
Matt's 13, okay?
What's your question there, Matt? Hey, in the Jewish faith, he's a man.
If I masturbate more than 2 times a day, I usually get some sort of heartburn.
Heartburn? But to describe to me what you mean by heartburn.
It's like a burning sensation up in my upper chest to my throat.
Do you have any, are you lying down when you do this?
It really depends.
I'm just wondering if there are things that you're doing.
I know, you're thinking of jismic reflux.
They can predispose to reflux, like eating before you lie down and then lying down for a long period of time.
You should never go swimming after you eat, et
cetera. Yeah, see, there's probably some pattern here,
right,
which is you whack off when you get home from school after you eat a snack.
Cheetos, yeah.
You eat a bag of Cheetos.
And you wonder why your penis is orange.
A six or a jolt, and then you spread out and have at yourself, and you think it's related to the masturbation, but it's related to you being horizontal.
Right, and the jolt.
Are you horizontal?
Sometimes.
You're on your back?
Sometimes.
Do you take aspirin or anti-inflammatories or anything like that?
Not.
Tetracycline?
No.
Okay. You know what you should do if you have that reflux is you're supposed to prop your mattress up
That's
at an
right.
angle,
That's
and
right.
that way the sperm doesn't land on you, too. I mean, it actually hits your feet. You know what I mean? It's more of a rainbow shot than it is that salvo that just goes straight up in the air. Let me tell you about sperm,
oh,
Kobe.
Please. Oh, yeah, please.
Oh, I'm all ears.
You know, each year people are killed on, you know, New Year's because they folks go outside and they fire their guns up in the air, and then the bullet eventually comes down and kills somebody. It goes straight up, comes straight down, puts a hole in someone's head. That's the way sperm is. If they would just fire the gun at the right angle, it'd just fly off into the
you get
distance.
The trajectory
you
right.
Get the trajectory right. At least they wouldn't be killed. I'm saying you fire a gun straight up in the air, you can be killed. If you fire it at an angle, you may kill somebody else with the sperm, but you're not going to kill yourself. Right? Right.
Good point.
Uh-oh.
The sound's gone here.
Kobe, what are you known for in the business? What's your maneuver? I mean, what do you do? Oral sex?
I do a little bit of everything. Dibble, dabble, you know.
You dabble in everything?
Yeah, yeah. Mm. I think just the energy level's always a 10 plus, so
really?
That's what I'm known
you
for.
You enjoy having sex with the guys? I mean, you having a good time?
And girls.
And girls, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I definitely enjoy my work.
Now, what if you were alone? Would you like it more with the person, or is it a turn-on and a thrill to know that there's people around?
I'm actually either excite me. I mean, work is great, and I get all excited about going to work, and, oh, yay, today's a work day. But off-screen, it's great,
true.
Too. It's even better, actually.
It's just better off-screen.
Yeah, work makes me appreciate my off-screen more.
Who are you more attracted to, me or Drew? Seriously.
Okay, who's our next caller?
Uh-oh, that means me.
Yikes.
You gotta, are you engaged or something?
No,
what's
I'm single.
What finger is that? All right. let me smell that ring finger.
Guess where I've been.
All right, working? Justin?
Yes?
You're 17.
Yes.
You were married?
Was.
Adult film star Mark Davis?
Yes, for 3 years.
I know a guy named Mark Davis.
Not the same one.
Really? That's that Paul, the 55-year-old intern? No. This guy kind of a Jewish guy, parts his hair in the middle?
Definitely no.
No.
He's English.
I see. Oh, he's a big hunky guy?
Yes.
Yeah, I think I don't know if you're aware of this, but he had sex with Jenna Jameson once.
Yes, oh yeah.
Yeah.
He's had sex with everybody in the business, actually.
He's cheated on you. That's all I'm saying. Oh, of course, that's not going to last. You can't marry you two in the industry. That's
actually,
insane.
It was the right guy, just the wrong time.
Okay. What
seriously,
does that mean?
We're best friends. We're best friends now. We really are.
How long were you married?
3 years.
All right. Seems like a long time. Justin?
Yes?
You're 17. What's up?
I've been with my girlfriend for about, 6 months. And, the last month and a half, she kind of decided that we were going to have sex. And both of us, both 3 to 4 times that we've done it, none of us have orgasmed at all, and I mean I don't know. We try to talk about it and stuff, but I just feel like I don't know anything about it because she was my first time, and sex hasn't been a real big thing in my family. My father is a minister, and so every Sunday he gets up on the pulpit, and it kind of makes me feel kind of bad about doing bad things, and I don't know if that plays a factor in it or anything at all, but I want to make her feel happy or whatever, and I've tried.
Okay, relax there, boy.
Okay,
he's a real Don Juan, this Justin. Justin, you're doing way too much thinking, brother.
It's guilt.
How old is he?
17.
17.
Okay.
Have you done any oral sex on her?
No, I've never done that.
Yeah.
You might want to try that.
That's all they want, Justin. sad, but true. And that way, if you just performed oral sex on her, in God's eyes, you wouldn't be having sex, and, you wouldn't feel as guilty. See what I'm saying, Justin?
Yeah. Well, I have a real phobia of doing. I have no idea what I'm doing at all. And
all right. Well, let's ask Kobe and find out what a woman likes. Okay.
All right.
Is that all right?
That's fine.
All right. Just listen, and take some notes, Kobe.
Well, the oral thing is definitely a nice thing. Yes, Adam is correct on that.
That's right.
But if you feel bad on not being
I know
too
what they want. I don't give it to them, but I know in theory what they want. I actually have a day laborer perform oral sex on my ladies, and then I move in.
For what?
for the nap.
Don't feel bad about not being experienced. That's the fun of sex, is that you learn. So together you all can learn what turns each other on, and don't force issues, and just do it naturally. It'll be a lot more fun. It's like a learning process. I mean, I'm 27, and believe me, I'm just now getting the hang of certain things.
What is the technique, though, for oral sex? Not only for you.
Whatever you do, don't do the ABCs. Girls know when you're doing that.
All right. So
whoever told that was a lie.
What is the technique?
And what is the best technique? You should kiss her down there like you would kiss her mouth on her face.
Interesting.
Their lips too.
Interesting. All right.
Yeah, you suck it, you play with it, you kiss it lightly, you breathe heavy on it, everything. It's just another set of lips just down south.
Yeah. I got the breathing heavy part because of the deviated septums. I guess like I can, I you know, the woman's vagina gets sucked halfway down my wind tunnel and then just push back out. I guess I can't breathe through my nose.
It's like a cartoon.
Yeah. Nah, I can barely breathe through my nose, so it's like I gotta be like, okay, I'm gonna have oral sex. You okay? No, here I go. No, you had enough yet? That was not orgasm. No, you're not done. Hold on. All right, I'm going back down there. And hold on a second. Let me hyperventilate. I can stay down for another 30 seconds. Okay. Here we go. I'm getting down there. You ready? All right. Are you focused this time? Here we go. Okay. It's like I'm pearl diving. I'm trying to get a sponge or something from the ocean floor.
They don't make sponges anymore.
They don't make sponges anymore?
No. Today's sponges, they stopped making them. Just a little FYI for you.
I mean the...
I know, but I'm throwing one at you.
It was interesting, though. They don't make that sponge.
They stopped again?
No.
Why is that? Is birth control, they don't make the sponge? Does it work?
Yeah.
Yeah, why did they stop that?
You would think they would have kept that one on the show.
It comes and goes. Are you sure it's again taken off?
Well, I don't know. I'm on the pill. I've not looked for that in a long time.
Because it did for a while. It was off. And then Seinfeld did a whole big...
I know. Is he sponge-worthy?
I didn't hear that.
It was a great episode.
The whole episode about the fact the sponge was not available.
She only had so many left.
Oh, I see. Interesting. You can't reuse those things?
Okay, no? It's kind of like a tampon, Andrew.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
And you say...
How
many times can you use a tampon, Andrew? Really? You can't reuse a sponge?
It's like when people say, can I borrow a tampon? Why would you want to borrow
it? They are, not to use a sensitive word as it pertains to contraception, but they are impregnated with the spermicidal agents that are no longer present after a certain period of time.
I see. And you can't reintroduce those into the sponge. Michelle?
Yes.
You're 29?
Yes.
What's up?
I have a question about my three-year-old niece. I'm worried that she maybe has been molested. She's got a lot of problems. I don't really know where to start. Like, for instance, she lives with my grandmother and not her own mother, who's moved out of the house.
What's up with her mother?
She was really young when she had the baby, and I don't know. She's just got a lot of problems. Like, she's had a lot of outbursts, and my mom thought that maybe she needed some sort of, you know, drugs. So they had her on, like, some psychological drugs.
At age 3?
No. This is my sister. And she's just always had a lot of problems. And when she got pregnant, she kept it, and then she got married and moved out and left my niece over with my mom.
Wow.
And so now she's having these outbursts where she wakes up screaming in the middle of the night and she can't be calmed down. It's like anger outbursts where she can't be controlled.
Mm-hmm.
And she says she wants to be good. And then she says, no, I don't want to be good. I want to be bad. And she like masturbates until she's red and like throbbing.
Being abandoned by your mom.
It's going to be me tonight when I get home with those Kobe Tai videos, by the way.
Being abandoned by your mom is pretty heavy by itself.
How old was she when she was abandoned?
I guess it's probably only been maybe 6 months.
Oh, yeah.
But it sounds like something else was going on here. I mean, but understand, kids will masturbate and do very strange exhibitionistic kinds of behaviors when they feel aggressive and threatened and angry. It may not be that she was sexually abused, though it certainly brings that question into focus.
Getting dropped off at 2.5 is, that's got to be
devastating. Heavy duty, yeah.
It hasn't really been there for her, like, emotionally. There's not that bond. It's more like a play thing for her. It's not like it's her daughter. It's more like it's a play
toy
thing.
All right. And where's mommy now?
She's living with her new husband and her new baby, who now is also having these, I don't know, she neglects the new baby.
All right, hold on. New baby. That's what I'm talking about. Listen, that's, I'm all right with the government stepping in on someone like that. That's it. New baby.
Can't handle one.
What are the chances you're going to F up the new kid? Well, 1 zillion is 1,000%, or is it can only go to 100?
No, you can, it's...
I can go to 1,000%?
Go wherever you want.
1,001%. Yeah, I'm sure she's a role model to all young parents with the new kid, right? She's turned over a new leaf.
It's just horrible to watch it. As
all right, hey, listen, you're her sister.
Right.
Why don't you say to her, hey, honey, get on some birth control. You're screwing up the planet.
I've said that since she was, like, you know, 17 years old, but it doesn't sink in. Nothing sinks in.
Where is she coming from? Where's your dad?
Well, we have different dads.
All right. See, that's where I step in already. Nor plant.
It all started then.
You know?
Yeah, well, I
lived in a house where everything was sort of swept under the rug. A born-again Christian family.
Oh, boy. You only get born again after you get strung out on heroin or kill somebody, though.
Exactly, and I moved out when I was about 13. I moved in with my dad because I couldn't stand it, but my sisters got left there, and that was their parents, so they had no choice but to be brought up in that environment, and my parents also never let them do anything on their own. Everything was... you know, done for them, you know, any situation that they could get into that was, you know, trouble, they were bailed out, and they just don't have any self, you know, confidence, and I don't know.
Michelle, so this is your half-sister, then?
She's my half-sister, but she's like my sister.
She's like your sister, and I think you have to appeal to the whatever conscience she has about her children, and why don't you ask her if she knows anything about this? I mean, I don't know what else to do. Her to stop having kids, please.
The child is going to need some treatment already, and so let's work on that. It doesn't really matter what happens.
Here's why. Here's what I do when I'm in charge, by the way, and I'm goddamn serious here. What an amazing turn of events. She comes from a family with two different parents, where kids were raised, and what a shock that she's had a child with one husband and then has had a child with another man.
Here's where it started.
What a shock with the Taboo 2 theme song. Don't you dare blame that song for this.
Yes, he does.
No, it's this thinking. Think about how screwed up this thinking is. Just look at the
lyrics. He knows how to please in every detail.
This was the decade.
One more line, come on. He can do more than you'd ever imagine, and do it with style. He does it with me. Oh, yes, he does. Yeah. Kobe isn't even looking down at the lyric sheet anymore. She's looking right at me.
I'm looking at you for inspiration.
Oh, yes, he does.
But this is the...
I'm getting hot.
In the 70s, it was, hey, this is cool. This is all right. This is the guy's expressing himself. Hey, he loves his mom, loves his sister. This is the attitudes that were in the 70s. This is what screwed us up.
Oh,
here it is.
This is a porn movie, Drew, please.
I'm just saying, that's
free
where
love.
It all started. That's why they were paying the popper now.
Shut up, Drew. Wait a minute. Do we have to pay the piper?
The piper.
There you go. Paying the popper. Jennifer?
Hello.
Uh-oh.
You're
39?
Yeah.
Oh, you're a guy, right?
Well, I used to be a guy, but I'm a transsexual.
Ooh, baby. What's going on?
Well, 10 years ago, I had my surgery, so I'm a woman now, and I'm taking hormone replacement therapy, and my sex drive has gone kaput. And I used to have a lot of sex because it was a lot of fun, but now it's like, I had my testosterone level checked and it's almost none.
Well, you're taking estrogen.
Same with me.
Why don't you take some testosterone also?
Well, because I read somewhere that if you take testosterone, it'll help your sex drive.
Yeah, so why don't you do that with the estrogen?
Hold on, let's do a little reenactment.
Okay.
My testosterone levels almost nil, and no sex drive.
Why don't you take some testosterone with the estrogen?
Because I read somewhere that testosterone helps your sex drive.
That was what happened.
Hey, Jennifer?
Yeah, but I don't want to get masculinized anymore because I was masculine enough and I'm fighting. I don't want to go that direction.
Well, I say, well...
Well, why don't you just... what about some Spanish fly or Viagra or something? Why don't you...
Yohimbe.
Yohimbe, some rhino tusks, some bear pancreas, whatever those crazy Asians eat.
Those are more vasodilators, though. Those are more for guys.
Yeah, but you still kind of have that system going, right?
Well, no.
Isn't that how you get aroused?
Well, that's the problem. I don't get aroused by much of anything anymore.
Well, listen, why do you need to get aroused? All you gotta do is hold still. You're a chick now.
Oh, because we're animals, though.
Who's an animal?
Aren't you? I am an animal.
You are in a form of animal. Yeah, I'd rather hump a bear, to tell you the truth.
But this is interesting. We've always wondered what would happen if a woman were like a man. You know what I mean? Here you go.
What do you got going on downstairs, so Jennifer? I mean, what do you know?
I have the prettiest pussy you'll never see.
Really?
Oh, now come on. I begged a different way. No, just kidding. Have you seen mine?
I'm gonna examine Kobe's like I'm a gynecologist when I get home today. Jennifer,
go ahead.
It looks good down there?
Oh, it's pretty.
Is it?
It's so much prettier than it ever was before.
Had a second job done?
Why is it I have the feeling I'd be disappointed if I actually got a good close-up look at that? So you had your penis removed.
Well, it was my birth defect.
Right. But for our sane listeners who are trying to follow along, we'll call it a penis.
Okay.
And you had that removed.
Yeah.
And when they removed that, they put a vagina on there, like Mr. Potato Head.
Well, it allowed me to flower and be free, yeah.
Right. And I want to know what that vagina looks like.
It looks like a pussy.
And,
But you can't get pregnant. It's just the look.
Jennifer, I don't think you're allowed to say that anymore. And what's going on in there? You have a clitoris?
Yeah.
And you have lips?
Yeah.
And what are the other parts? Are there any other parts?
The clitoris was a shaved down penis, right?
I don't lubricate like a genetic woman would, but it's pretty real.
And would a guy, if a guy was with you and sober, I know you're going to have to use your imagination here, would he know the difference?
Sometimes. Some people would. If you're intuitive, yeah.
Intuitive. I know, but what if he could only see that part of you?
It's close.
It's close.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, I look at a woman who was born a woman, and it ain't pretty half the time. I mean, I got to be honest, I don't even like those. I can only imagine the bad jobs, these afterthought numbers, you know what I mean? I mean let's face it, the vagina on a lot of women doesn't look great anyway. I mean, it's not that they don't have other good parts on them, but let's face it. I mean, it doesn't even work on women sometimes. I can only imagine how it works when they, you know, there used to be a penis there. It's like removing a tree and putting a wishing well in its place. There's roots, there's things there. It's not a good idea. All right, listen, we got to take a break. I got to get back to Jennifer, though. I want to know a little bit more about this.
All right,
I think that everyone has had a sex change is nuts. And
she has a birth defect.
You have to be nuts in order to do it. You have to be nuts to get your genitalia cut off. And people say, but wait a minute, I'm not nuts. I just know that I'm, a woman trapped inside a man's body. Yes, that's the essence of nuts. That's how you get to be nuts. Right there, stop. That's nuts. You see? No, nuts. I'm not talking about think you're Napoleon. I'm not talking about mad scientists. I'm talking about you have a penis, a scrotum, and an Adam's apple, and you think there's a chick trapped inside you somewhere dying to get out. That's what nuts is.
I know you want these nuts.
Thank you. We'll take a little break. Kobe Tai, who couldn't possibly have anyone else trapped inside of her, she's too damn skinny, is here tonight. And we'll be back. We'll sing a little more. Oh. We'll sing a little more the Taboo 2 theme song after this.
God in heaven.
We're back with more Loveline. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Kobe Tai is our guest tonight. She's a beautiful young nubile adult film star. You can see her naked on www.vividvideo.com or Kobe Tai with the dot and the com and the same thing. We got to figure out a way to abbreviate this. Dot, you know, the W's and the com are at the end, and then the Kobe Tai's in the middle. There has to be some way that we don't have to go through that. I'm sure somebody's figured this out, haven't they?
I mean, why we don't? You don't have to say it anymore. People assume all that.
So
just
say
KobeTai.com, vividvideo.com.
Yeah, but why with the .com even?
That's the address.
Yeah, but all of them have .com at the end.
No, some are .org, .net.
Earthlink, Yahoo.
But isn't all the commercial stuff .com?
Mm-mm.
And the org stuff organization?
Not necessarily, or .net.
Mm-hmm.
Well, wait a minute.
Let's just go to calls.
We're back to the point.
Don't cramp you on talk whatever to point I was making. Yeah. Jennifer is 10 years. It's 10 years since the feminine side was
the birth
unleashed.
Defect was repaired.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was twice a virgin.
Right, right. What do you do for a living? You must work at a video store.
No, I don't know if I want to say.
What kind of work do you do?
I'm a nurse.
Yeah, boy, that's nuts times two. You know. Here's how I would. I'd be like, I want to introduce you a friend of mine. I want to tell you a little something about her. She was a he. She is a transsexual. Yeah, that ain't good. And she's working as a nurse. Oh my God, no. Dear God, no. She must be nuts. All nurses are nuts. What happened to you, Jennifer? Something must have happened to you. Something horrible.
Well, I suffered for a long time, and then I finally got over it.
Yeah, but who suffered? Who suffered on you?
At whose hands?
At whose hands? What kind of situation did you grow up in?
A supposedly normal, boring
craft. Who was it? Someone was a drug addict, or somebody raped you, or something.
No.
Come on.
That was part of my history. I used to dabble, but nothing real.
What happened to you growing up, though? What kind of... Where's your dad?
I used to run away from...
Right.
My dad's... I don't talk to my dad.
He beat the crap out of you or something?
No. He intellectually abused me.
What does that mean?
Well, it means an autism supposed to's are much more important than anything that I ever had.
Never encouraged you, never gave you support.
Not even close.
Yeah, but kids don't run away from their parents unless they're being overtly abusive, like rageful, awful abuse.
Well, if you're devalued to the point where you don't exist, then not physical, though, and that's not drugs.
But was he calling you awful things?
No, it's more ignoring what I was as a human being and not acknowledging.
So you're trying to do things for attention?
Like, for example, for my brother's wedding, he made me dress up in guy's clothes if I wanted to attend. Oh, excuse me,
Yeah, but how about when you were 6 years old?
By the way, that'd be my policy, too.
I don't remember a lot of six-year-olds.
Listen.
Why?
I don't know why.
Well,
You think, listen, something happened to you. I mean, come on, let's be honest. Something had to have happened.
Well, I think the good part that happened is I found help, and I have a path that's good. But I was really wondering about my sex drive and how I can help that without turning more masculine again.
As a woman now... Do you only have sex with men?
Well, see, I gave up on men because I kind of don't like penises. And women are a lot more comfortable. But that doesn't mean I don't want to go back to that.
Right. You may rediscover the penis.
The transsexual
I'm
male...
looking for mine.
The male to female transsexuals I have dealt with were all lesbians.
Of course. Because you can't ask them to... God forbid they make sense. Do you know what I mean?
Well, I spent so long running away from penis that... But I still get pleasured by that.
Was it one giant penis, or are you just saying symbolically you ran away from penis?
Because that was when I was running away from myself. You know?
I see. It was a metaphor. I see. I pictured a giant penis that had broken loose from the circus or something. It was chasing you down the street. You're speaking metaphorically is what you're saying,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. I should pay attention. Did you guys know that, or do you think it was the giant penis?
I was just visioning it like Woody Allen film or something.
like the giant penis that crushed Tokyo and attacked Mothra.
All right, Jennifer.
All right. Jennifer.
I'm glad you're happy.
No, she's not. She wants to be more aroused.
Well, you are made up of X and Y chromosomes. And as such, your body responds differently to male and female hormones than an XX. Not only do you not produce them, you also respond differently to them. And a woman, a big component of female sexuality is receptivity. And that's what estrogens do to women, is make them sort of open to and receptive to the advances of a male. The progestational agents can make them sort of aggressive in a masculine way. But a big, big, big piece of their sexuality is receptivity. Men don't have that.
Yeah,
so all you get is suppression of the male aspect of sexuality. And if you're going to experience your sexuality, you've got to activate those systems that are involved in male sexual expression.
Right, but when you're
and that means either reducing your estrogen or adding testosterone.
All right. But also, all bets are off because you're whacked out of your mind. You know what I mean? Who the hell knows what's going on sexually? You're out of your mind. All bets are off. That's what I'm saying. There's going to be times of hypersexuality, and there's going to be dormant periods where you can completely close down sexually.
If I put you on estrogen, you'd be shut down.
I would? And what else? What else did I get?
Sing that song better.
Get breast. His testosterone level and your testes would raise up off the floor.
Yeah. What? Could I have a little testosterone?
Also?
What if you got me a little testosterone going?
Then you'd be hypersexual and aggressive.
I would?
Yeah.
All right. How about all that?
And then you'd shut down.
Oh, after that?
Yeah.
Can you give me some for Kobe tonight? A little of that Kobe beef, you know?
And he said his testosterone levels were nil.
All right.
So,
Rick?
Yeah.
Rick, you're 23.
Hi, I just wanted to tell Kobe hello.
Hi, sweetie.
I think she's great. I work as an intern pharmacist right now. I'm in pharmacy school. And I just wanted to tell you guys how much I agree with this morning after pill. Many times every day I see 15, 16-year-old girls coming in getting their prenatal vitamins, and it's terrible.
But go read the, you're a pharmacy student, read the literature on how this thing works.
I agree with it 100%.
But
you're so much better off.
But forget the better off. Read actually how it works. This whole business of it being a suppressor of implantation is nonsense. It has the same probability of doing that as the contraceptive pill used the way it was designed to be used.
So it prevents ovulation.
It works just like the regular contraceptive pill.
Yeah, I hear you guys talk about it all the time, and I think it's a great idea.
Hey, so you're saying if the woman has already ovulated, it's not going to do anything?
The woman has already ovulated, you're going to get pregnant.
Hey, Rick?
Yeah.
You're not calling from Southern California, are you?
Yeah, I'm in California.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, not Southern California, though, right?
No, I'm from Southern California, but I'm away at farm school right now.
Why?
All right.
Why'd you ask that?
Well, he won't be able to work as a pharmacist in Southern California.
What?
What's your ethnic heritage, Rick?
I'm white.
You're white? No, yes. Sorry. There'll be no employment for you in California. Only bizarre mixtures, what I like to call the Johnny Quest villain.
Yeah.
Ethnicities are accepted. You cannot share common language with any pharmacist in Southern California. They're evil, and don't take no offense to this, Kobe, but a bizarre sort of Asian. It's like Iranian guy got it on with a Chinese chick, and someone sprinkled in like some weird Ukrainian thing in there somewhere, and together they had just the meanest, foulest person you could communicate least with, and they don't hire white folks to work as pharmacists in Southern California, Rick. So,
I guarantee I'm definitely the minority at pharmacy school.
It's about
two-thirds Asian females right now.
They must have, like, do they have classes in abusing people who come? Like, I mean, do they do, like, repeat after me? You wait now!
Oh, God.
That's next semester, I think.
Okay, that was very good. And everybody, class, repeat after me. You pay top dollar, round eye.
Ciao. Ding dong day.
Okay.
Let's say it's another one. Computer down. Down.
You've been here for 4 hours. You go now.
You go now. You call other pharmacy. Not this one. What your name? What? C O No, C, we don't have it. You'll come back. You'll come back long time. I have insurance. You don't have insurance no more. Computer down. Can I have my drugs? You pay top dollar. Then you'll come back. We give you one pill at a time, Charlie. You get one pill.
Charlie. Let's go. Break.
You get one pill, you come back tomorrow, we give you next pill.
Oh. Will this night ever end?
No, we fill. And no, say we fill.
Happy birthday.
Oh, my God. I don't know. I don't even know what nationality it is in there, but it's whatever it is, it's the meanest, least communicative, or say that word
easy for
me,
you
Drew.
Say.
Ethnicity in the entire world. And I don't know what it is about people are getting involved with pharmacy that have no interest in conversation or human beings at all, but man, these are like some kind of weird androids. I'd rather, I swear to God, you'd be better off with one of the bears, one of the animatronic bears from the Country Bear Jamboree back there. Really would do a better job than the pharmacist. At least you wouldn't get abused. You'd just get like a guy with a cider jug, you know, who was inept. Oh, my God. It's always a disaster. Always a disaster. And what is it? I mean, like, you're half Chinese, right, Kobe?
And half Japanese,
Does everybody in China and Japan want to be a pharmacist? Or how does that work? Why? What is it with this ethnicity that's so attracted to the pharmaceutical business?
Medicine.
Wow. It's uncanny.
Starts back in the opium days. We used to smoke opium.
Is it the rich tradition of the Chinese herbalist?
Yes.
And, I mean, is that what
herbs
I mean? Is it the fact that these people have had it inbred in their culture for millions of years, and that we've had it in a relatively short period of time in the Caucasian culture? Is that what that is? What is that? All right, Drew, you don't know. We're gonna take a little break here. Kobe Tai is here. She'll be back to explain more about the ethnicities and what they do best. And this isn't what they do best. It's just what they're attracted to. That's frightening. I don't mind it if you do so. You know, if you're an Italian guy who cooks real well, then that's your love. That's fine. But if you can't fly an airplane, don't insist on doing that. Okay, we'll take a little break. We'll be back. We'll sing the
Taboo song.
Yeah, after this. It's Loveline.
Adam, before you sing, can we at least take these two calls that have been on hold for 90 minutes?
Okay.
Please.
I'm sure they'd like to hear the Taboo theme again.
I know, given that we've taken like three calls tonight.
Well, I've been doing, talking about very important topics.
I know, you're pulling your penis off, singing songs.
All right. Kobe Tai, I guess, an adult film star. Natalie?
Uh-huh.
You're 16?
Yeah.
You haven't had a period in 2 months?
Uh-huh.
What does that have to do with Taboo 2?
Huh?
Any chance you're pregnant?
No, I haven't done anything like sexual or anything, but...
Okay.
Are you athletic?
Uh-huh.
Lost a lot of weight?
Hmm?
Have you lost any weight recently?
Not really.
Are you excessively athletic? Are you doing like cross-country running or anything like that?
I've done volleyball.
Okay.
I bet her body fat is really low, which is why she doesn't have a period.
Do you have irregular periods? Have you had that your whole life?
Mm-hmm.
Your regular periods?
Yeah, my regular periods, yeah.
My regular period?
Gosh.
Hey, hold on a second.
Oh, boy.
Now, do you want to hear that theme song, Taboo 2? Or do you want to watch Natalie chase her tail for another 20 minutes? Hmm? Huh?
All right, let me try to answer.
By the way, this is what it's like talking to a pharmacist.
Yeah. Huh? Yeah? What? No.
Do you have irregular periods? My regular periods? Yep.
No, don't go back.
I got a doctor. Natalie.
Yeah.
I'm trying to figure out a way to have your periods always been off and on?
No.
They've been on?
Mm-hmm.
Every month the same?
Yep.
Okay. Like a clock?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
Now she's
Are you stressed out about something? Maybe a semester test or something?
Well, yeah, kind of. Like just family problems.
All right. Well, that in itself is enough to cause you to miss your period. Other things, thyroid problems, plenty of other things that can do
so
it, too.
So she not worry about it if she hasn't had sex?
It's less of an issue. If it goes more than 3 months, have it checked out. But
okay.
It's probably going to be nothing.
Nick?
Yeah?
You went down on your girlfriend?
Yeah.
Oh, you're just going to go through all this secret
I got to get
song.
To I gotta get the theme song.
Oh, my God.
Went down on your girlfriend. Her stomach and clitoris started hurting.
Yeah, like that night, her stomach was hurting. Like she said she had to go pee.
Well, she had a urine infection, probably.
And then, like, that's what it is?
She has a urine infection? Yeah, of course.
Is that what that is?
It burned when she went tinkle?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, she's got a urine infection.
Okay, there you go. Should we take one more call,
sure,
or should we get right to the theme?
No, one more, please.
Okay, what do you want, 4, 2? Denise?
Mm-hmm.
You're 32?
Yep.
What's your question?
I want to know if I send you a blank videotape, I want a copy of the Taboo 2 video.
Why?
Because we watch videos often, and it must be pretty good if you went to all that trouble to get a copy.
Who's we?
My boyfriend and I.
I understand, Adam is not alleging this is good, it's just that it's a piece of his youth, a lost piece.
Hey,
it's something
right.
He sort of he cut his teeth on, if you will.
Yeah, it's a missing piece of my past.
It's
his woobie blanket.
Hasn't the song that he's been singing tonight over and over convinced you that this is maybe not a great piece of art?
Well, I just started listening. I kind of got a piece of that of his vocal.
Would you like to hear it again?
You didn't get the whole song?
Whether you'd like to or not, you're going to.
Well, hang on, Denise. I'm going to sing that. And no, I will not copy you off a copy of that because each time you play the video without masturbating is one less time it can be masturbated to. Do you see what I'm saying?
Some sort of cosmic, universal scale.
Well, look at it this way. It is not an infinite number of times. It is finite. When you play a video, maybe it's played 100 times, maybe it's played 153 times, but there is a number. And when you start copying them off, that is one less.
That you can play a video before, what, it rips apart or something?
Well, I'm just saying they have
a number.
A number.
So maybe that number is 20,000. You think you're going to get up
Doesn't
there?
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
You feel like it's a waste.
This is why I want a son. All right, let's
Get it over with.
Let's move forward with the show here and sing the theme song to Taboo 2 with the beautiful Toby. I mean, Toby. That's
Ty
a better
Cobb.
Way. Kobe Tai, the beautiful adult film star. Toby Kai.
All the time.
You ready? We got it? All right, now let's really kick this one up a notch.
All right,
again,
here we go.
The theme song to Taboo 2, Adam Carolla, Kobe Tai. Here we
go. 2, 3, 4.
He has it all. Yes, he does. He knows how to please in every detail.
Jesus Christ in heaven.
He can do more than you'd ever imagine. Do it with style.
He does it with me.
Oh, yes, he does. I know that you thought
that you knew him.
Favorite line here.
And maybe you did, but you don't.
Everyone.
He only reveals what he wants you to see.
And then show it all.
And when he does,
he satisfies me.
Shut up, damn it!
If you only knew just what he could do, you'd want him to if you only knew. It keeps getting better. It gets better, Drew.
Jesus Christ, heaven.
Thank you. And I got to tell you, there was a real bit of magic that took place.
I was feeling it.
At the beginning, about a third into it, when Kobe and I both dropped our scripts, and we just looked each other in the eye.
Pointed.
And we pointed at each other. You know what I mean?
I guess I was the only one that actually was present during that moment. Actually witnessed it.
We were not in this room, is what I'm saying.
It was like a sunny,
we were somewhere above.
Sort of a sunny share moment.
We'd transcended the material, the studio, the audio.
It
was just me and you.
Let's continue to transcend, and we'll be right back.
This is this crazy mixed-up world. Horns honking.
Mm-hmm.
Violence,
mm-hmm.
The economy, pollution, but for that one split second, it was just me and Kobe.
I'm feeling a little bit clumped.
Thank you. We'll be back.
What's up?
Loveline. Loveline will be right back.
I'm glad you're here.
Seven.
Love Line.
What's up, huh?
We're back to 7.
94.7 NRK.
And why can't we figure
all right, here we go. KobeTai.com. Check it out.
Please bookmark drdrew.com. Check out the things we've been talking about tonight. You can find out more about at drdrew.com. Our chats are up and running, and they are state of the art. Get involved there.
Vividvideo.com. And we should print the lyrics to Taboo 2 on the drdrew.com. That would get
if you want
hits.
To.
Why don't you do that, Drew?
No, it's going to be your little expression, your self-expression.
All right,
we're going to put it in the forums.
I'll put that up there.
All right, on your behalf, I'll put it up tomorrow.
You'll get some hits, all right?
All right.
Get the lyrics to that.
Okay.
Really.
Just some feedback for you.
Really all learn.
Right. All right, it's done. It is done.
You kids are so...
hear that, guys? You're putting it up tomorrow morning.
You're so into this grunge rock and stuff, but let's hear about some real music, some real lyrics, lyrics that mean stuff, songs about guys, you know, raping their, you know... sister and mom, you know.
At the same time. Yes, he does.
I have to go to sleep. I have to go to sleep right away. She's going to haunt.
Knows how to please in every detail.
We're out of time.
All right, that is it. God bless you, Kobe Tai.
Thank you for having me.
Then you'd ever imagine.
And do it with style.
And what he does it on me.
Oh. Here we go.
Okay.
Yeah.
Until next time, it's Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew saying mahalo.
Well, now.
This has been Loveline. The stuff expressed on Loveline is not necessarily the stuff of the staff, management, sponsors, or anyone else, including Westwood One Entertainment. Loveline is produced by Ann Wilkins-Ingold.